The Minisforum BD790i X3D is a weird board for weirdos. No, not because it's an ITX board with an embedded CPU. That's becoming more common. And it's definitely not weird for this built-in cooler. That's pretty cool. No, it's weird for a reason that you might not expect. A reason that might make it one of the best off-the-shelf options if you're pairing with a discrete GPU in a small sub-4-liter build, like the Skyreach 4 Tiny. No, I love the ASRock DeskMini series. They've been a go-to choice for sub-4-liter DGPU builds because of their socketed CPU, dual M.2 slots, and a layout that leaves plenty of room for a GPU with full access to display outputs. But here's the catch. You're running the GPU over a 4x PCIe lane. That's not a problem for today's graphics cards, but tomorrow's? Well, my 9060 Nitro Plus already hogs all the bandwidth it possibly can get. And powering everything? Oof, that's where it gets tricky. You either need a dual voltage setup or commit to modding. Then there's also the mini PC route, which I've explored a lot. My current daily gaming machine is the Minisforum AI X1 Pro. It's fast, loaded with memory and I.O., and genuinely impressive, not just for its size either. I love it. But if you're integrating into a Tiny, you still need to do work around dual power inputs, and its design, it limits its flexibility. It's great, but not as straightforward as using a normal ITX motherboard. Okay, so why not just use normal ITX? Well, of course you can, and again, I got videos on that too, but it has its own set of challenges. It gives you a lot of flexibility in the components that you choose. You can run a desktop CPU like the 9800X 3D, get all the bells and whistles of a flagship motherboard, and crank out really high benchmark scores. But it comes at a cost, both literally and thermally. In these compact builds, pushing that much power into a teeny tiny space means higher temperatures, more fan noise, and a tougher time with power delivery. It works, but it's a tightrope walk the whole way, and I know that I wouldn't want to daily drive it, just like I wouldn't want to get groceries in an F-350 dually. The heart is willing, but the parking space is limited. And this is where the BD790i X3D really stands out. It's the Goldilocks of solutions for ultra-small form factor ITX. It has an embedded CPU with its own cooler and efficient laptop silicon. It has two M.2 PCI Express Gen 5 4X slots, a full PCIe Gen 5 16X slots for your discrete GPU, and critically, DisplayPort pass-through, which makes this board ideal for something like the S4T because you don't need to run internal cables. Everything is passed right through the PCIe lanes, straight out the back. But who cares if you're stuck with a bad CPU? But that is not the case for the BD790i X3D. This board uses the 7945HX3D, blah, 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 blah. A mobile CPU with AMD's 3D V-Cache technology. Now, V-Cache is typically a desktop gaming performance feature, so having it here in a 100-watt part is rare and really interesting. Now, you might be thinking, 100-watt chip? I thought this was a 55-watt chip. You also might be thinking, didn't Minisforum already release something like this? Yes to both. The BD795i SE has nearly the same form factor and features, but the X3D version brings a big advantage in efficiency. Now, rather than me trying to invent the wheel and throwing a bunch of slides and benchmarks at you, I'm just gonna point you to someone who's already done the heavy lifting. Chris Russel from Chris Russel Tech ran detailed testing on the BD790i X3D, comparing it with the BD795i SE and desktop chips like the 9800 X3D and 9950X. Even better, he updated his testing recently with noise normalized thermals and a new BIOS. So here's his findings in his own words.
Thanks for the intro, Josh. In the Cinebench R24 multi-core test, the BD790 with a 7945HX3D scores 1,850 points, outpacing the regular 7945HX at 1,789, and due to a smaller core count, the 9800X3D, 1,320 points. More impressive is the thermal performance. While the desktop CPUs max out at 96 degrees, the HX3D and the BD790i tops out at just 79 degrees in a noise normalized scenario. That's some strong performance with far better efficiency. In Forza Horizon 5 at 1440p, no DLSS or frame gen, the 7945HX runs at 77 degrees while the HX3D sits at 69 degrees. That's an 8 degree difference and still holds up in FPS. For compact systems where thermal headroom is important, these margins are a big deal. Back to you, Josh.
Thank you, Kristen. You guys, make sure to check out his channel. He has one of the best small form factor channels out there. Okay, so for more money, you're getting pretty much the same performance as the BD795i SE, but way more efficiency. And yes, the integrated graphics are just there so you can plug in a monitor. If you need strong iGPU performance, please look elsewhere, like the AI X1 Pro with its 890M, which I love, or hold out for something wild like the Strix Halo, if you got the coin. But if your goal is to build something ultra compact, quiet, and capable with a discrete GPU with manageable thermals, this is the perfect Goldilocks combination of things that I have found so far. Of course, working in a sub-4-liter case is never frictionless, but if you want to see how I overcome the challenges step by step, stick around for my next video because I'm updating my dream PC, and the BD790i X3D is the board that I'm choosing to make it happen.